There's still confetti on the floor. Everyone, it's Kat, and you'll notice that I'm not coming to you in my normal text medium, but in a video. Yeah, so I decided that the topic that I'll be covering in this video is a little bit complicated to try to explain through text, and I really wanted to show you the magnificence of the three most beautiful days in Basel. I have been excited for Fastnacht ever since I found out that I'd be coming to Basel, Switzerland. For those of you who don't know, Fastnacht is actually the carnival in Switzerland. Carnival is actually found all throughout Europe and all over the Catholic world. But contrary to how it is practiced in America, in New Orleans, where people throw necklaces at each other and parade naked through the streets, Swiss Carnival is actually very different. In fact, even within Switzerland, Fastnacht differs from city to city. But I'm lucky enough to live in the city with the biggest, best, and oldest celebration. Basler Fastnacht actually began as early as 1200 AD. Some say that it started as a way of expelling winter and welcoming spring, but according to Basler historians, it started as a way of getting rid of food before fasting period started. And that's why it was actually first spelled Fastnacht, then changed to Fastnacht, and is now Fastnacht. Because there wasn't really any refrigeration at this time, whenever fasting started, all of a family's food would go bad. The city of Basel began having a giant feast for all of its citizens, where everyone would bring all their food together, and for 3 days they would eat everything. Bet you like this celebration already. And from there on, it developed into more of a celebration with parties and parades and music and costumes and what it is today. As I mentioned before, Carnival is actually a Catholic practice, but for those of you who are well versed in the history of Switzerland, you'll know that Basel actually reformed in 1520, making Basler Fastnacht the only Protestant Carnival in the world. There are many components to Basel's Fastnacht, but I'm going to be talking about four of them. The first, pre-Fastnacht activities. The second, the Morgenstreich. The third is Schießtreckzügli. I can't really say it, but here it's spelled. And the fourth is the cortege. So before Fastnacht even begins, there are a few activities in the city in which Baslers can kind of get involved and get into the Fastnacht spirit. The best of them is the Kinderumzug, or the Children's Parade. 5,500 children from both Baselstadt and Baselland come together and put on a parade on the Thursday before Fastnacht's Ferien begins. Lucky enough for me, my host mom is actually an elementary school teacher, so I got to join her and her class in the parade. It was so much fun and I had such an amazing time throwing confetti and giving out candy and getting weird looks for being a teenager walking in the elementary school parade. It was a great way to start off the festivities and get in the Fastnacht spirit. Take a look.
The purge. Two words. The purge. The lights go off. All of a sudden, the whole place is dark. A lot of people wearing scary masks.
All good against us. I'm sure that it's not even human people. And they're all like from another planet or something.
It's creepy. Super creepy.
Yeah. Then at the same time, I can't wait for there to be light outside. Because every now and again, it's like, he wants to know me. But it's great.
The city is alive and everyone's just waiting for it. You've got like lanterns up and suddenly at 4 a.m. all the lights go off. You're like, what the hell's going on? And then the flutes start playing and the drums start playing and people start walking through and they're all dressed and they've got like lanterns on, and that's literally the only light that you see because no one uses the flashes on their camera, and it's just something that you cannot believe. It's 4 a.m. in the morning and the entire city is alive with like music and I love that there was a sense of like community, like that everyone's part of something, and you can feel it in your stomach, in your chest, like you can feel the drums, you can feel the passion and the excitement, and yeah, I love it. So good.
There are a few things about Basler Fastnacht that really sets it apart from other Fastnachts in Switzerland, and one of those is being the Schießträgsigli. I can't really say it that well because I'm not Swiss, but here it is spelled. That is where small groups of people, sometimes four, sometimes two, sometimes only even one, walk through the Altstadt, or the old city, wearing costumes and masks and playing on their instruments. The only instruments used are the drums and the piccolo. It's really funny to see because you're just walking along and here comes another person, all costumed and just playing away. What's really unique about Basler Fastnacht is the presence of political satire in a lot of the floats in the parade. Baslers are known for being really funny and satirical, so it makes sense that a lot of their floats are going to express that. They use their floats to convey political messages and to comment on society and comment on the corrupt state of politics or anything that's wrong in the world. Now for the last component, the cortege. I mentioned the parade earlier, and that's exactly what it is. The cortege is actually just the parade for Fastnacht. There are two of them, one on Monday in the afternoon and one on Wednesday in the afternoon. In these parades, the Wachis, who are the people who wear masks and costumes and actually go on the floats or walk in the parade, hand out a variety of different goods such as oranges and flowers. For confetti. Confetti, or Rettli in Basel Swiss German dialect, is so popular for the Basel Fastnacht that it is actually said that it was created in Basel. Believe me when I say I have never seen so much confetti in my life. They throw it at you. They pour it on your head. It's actually a little bit scary because you'll just be walking and people will grab you by the arm and these guys will literally stick their hands down your shirt and pour confetti in. However, I will say it is pretty fun. Basler Fastnacht is a wonderful 3 days full of fun and festivities, and I'm so grateful that I got the chance to participate in such a wonderful Swiss tradition and that I got to share it with all of you. If you're ever in Europe towards the end of February, Basel's the place to be.